Hello, everyone. Welcome to the IoT Show. And today, on today's episode, we have Stephen Liu, who says that he can deploy AI and ML modules out to an edge using a few simple steps. Let's find out today on the IoT Show. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the IoT Show. I'm Vanessa Villa, and today we have Stephen Liu from Advantech. Hello, Stephen, and welcome to the show.
Hello, Vanessa. Thank you for inviting us.
So, Stephen, tell me a little bit more about what brings you onto the show today and what you have for us.
All right. I'm very excited to introduce our pipeline or kind of best practice to train and deploy and monitor AI models from the cloud to edge devices. You know that Advantech is a world leader in designing and making industrial computers or embedded systems from gateways to box PCs or motherboards and stuff with a global operation around 28 countries. And we've been doing that for almost 40 years. So in a way, we're kind of the expert of hardwares and especially AI engines and stuff. And we want to let more people to train and deploy their AI models more easily.
That's amazing. And what does this have to do with deploying AI more easily at the edge? What's Advantech's role in that?
We learned from a lot of customers that they are good at training AI models and they know the best about their domain or their industries, but they are having a hard time deploying, running their AI models on edge devices, say industrial PCs. And that's where Advantech comes in to help them. So we're not developing AI models, but we are developing a process or a set of tools that facilitates customers' cloud to edge AI deployment and monitoring.
And so you brought with us this really interesting visual to really emphasize that gap between training the AI ML model and deploying it on the edge. So can you tell me a little bit more about that?
Right, sure. Well, there are a lot of tools out there for you to train AI models locally. You can train it on your desktop, training server, and so on. But a lot of domain experts or on-site managers don't have that access or skill set or just don't have the time or the team to do it. So in that case, they should definitely turn to cloud AI or machine learning resources. But what's next? How are they going to put it onto the edge devices, onto the industrial PCs? And there are some pain points we've identified from our customers.
Yes. And so pain points from the customers, right? I mean, deploying on the edge, developing the AI and ML models themselves. I mean, all of this requires real-time monitoring and remote troubleshooting as well, because you can't necessarily access all of those devices, right? Once you have them fully deployed. So that's quite a challenging field. And so what does Advantech bring to the table in this regard?
Right. You're exactly right. These are the pain points. A lot of manpower, a lot of on-site maintenance and stuff. So what Advantech does is to leverage our almost 40 years of expertise on hardware device monitoring and control. So we've developed this homegrown device management platform called DeviceOn. So it's a platform that help you to remotely manage over 10,000 devices anywhere on any kind of environment. And there are a lot of features about it, but some popular ones are Docker container management, remote power on and off, and of course, over-the-air update of firmware or even operating system. And of course, we do a lot of remote real-time monitoring and notification. And this tool can also help customers to deploy the AI models on-the-edge devices at scale, and especially in containers.
And that's exactly where the Azure device catalog comes into play, right? We have several devices that have now been registered in the device catalog that are compatible with DeviceOn, correct?
That's right. That's right. We've been working with Microsoft and Azure very closely over the past few decades because we started with Microsoft licenses and we're a kind of early adopter of Azure services. In fact, the whole DeviceOn is hosted on Microsoft Azure. So it gets you availability, scalability, and a lot more security to manage the devices.
That's amazing. That's really a Microsoft homegrown business there that you have.
That's right. That's right. So what I'm going to show today is a kind of pipeline or a process or a best practice to deploy AI models or start from training and deployment and monitoring AI models from the cloud to the edge and then back to the cloud. There are two sides of the coin. One is AI model deployment, and the other is how to deal with inference data collection and monitoring from the edge to the cloud.
So we're starting here with the computer vision, the custom vision that you have created, right? How long did it take you to create this model?
Oh, it's super fast. It depends on the model, of course. It takes from minutes to 1 or 2 hours, and I would say that's all. But we've actually done quite a few projects around the world in different industries, but for simplicity's and confidentiality's sake, I'm going to use this fruit detection AI model to show you the process. And of course, you can imagine your own use cases or scenarios. So to put this into context, let's imagine a operation manager in a fruit distribution business. So he's streamlining the quality control process by AI model running on like 50 devices on a production or packaging line. So he's got the domain know-how. He can use customer vision to train a wonderful AI model. And let's start from there.
All righty, let's start from there. And so, okay, cool. You train your custom vision model, you've deployed it, and now that you've trained it, what's the next step? How do you access that?
All right, so we've constructed a pipeline on Azure DevOps, which is a CICD platform. So let's go to the pipeline here and see a device on MS IoT show project. And what you do is to just run the pipeline, and then it's getting all the jobs done for you. But let's take a look at what it really does. Well, for the first time, you should definitely set up configure the settings and to connect the dots from Azure Custom Vision and all the way to the next step, which is Azure Container Registry. And once it's all set, you just have to run the pipeline every time you've got a new model or you've improved your AI model. So assume that it's done, and then we'll turn to Microsoft Azure Container Registry. And this is the dashboard of the registry, and we're going to find the repository in the service area. So let's click on the repository, and there is one called DeviceOn Detect Fruits. You will find that we actually trained two AI models. One is called Fruits and one is called Banana. Very simple, very cute. And that's all. Now your AI model has been transported to this ACR, Azure Container Registry.
So now, you just went from developing your own custom vision using the CICD pipeline in Azure DevOps to then deploy it out into the container registry. Is that correct?
Exactly right.
That's amazing. That's really amazing. That's really streamlined.
Exactly. And many thanks to this wonderful platform and tools. Now it's time to deploy it onto the edge device. So I'm going to introduce you Advantech DeviceOn. It's a wonderful platform for you to manage all types of devices. This is a overview of your devices, events, and schedules. So if I click on the device list, I will see that in my account, there is a device group, which is NVIDIA Jetson. And there is a Advantech device called Air020. So if you click in, you will find a lot more details about that device. But that's not the point of today. Today, we are going to leverage the container management feature within DeviceOn. So again, we'll click on my device and see there are two containers deployed from the cloud. So how did I do it? First of all, let me go to the registry under the container management. I'm going to add a registry, which is Azure Container Registry. So here I'm going to put a name of it, something like MS IoT show and something like that. All right. And the URL actually comes from the Azure Container Registry page. So we would go to the access keys and find the registry name, server, URL, and credentials. We just copy and paste that onto DeviceOn. So we've got a container registry synced up and updated with the one on Azure Container Registry. Now it's time to deploy that container. So we can go back to the container device list and click in the NVIDIA Jetson Air020, and we'll see that there are two containers deployed but not yet running. So yes. I'm going to click the fruit detection container and start it. Yes, confirmed. And execution successfully confirmed.
Does this execute? Can you execute deploying these containers at the device level or at the device type level? How granular can you get at deploying these types of containers?
Wonderful question. So I can start and stop a few containers on one particular device. I can also do a kind of batch control over tens, if not hundreds of devices at once.
Wow, that's really great.
Right. And you know that the good thing about the container is that you don't have to worry about dependencies. So you just wrap up everything once and for all.
Amazing. So it looks like now the fruit container with that custom vision is running on that edge device. Shall we try and look at to see if it is running?
Yeah, why not? So if you turn to the other camera, you will see that we've set up this whole thing on the same table. So this is the Air020 model running Ubuntu and the container, and there is a camera looking at the different types of fruits on the table, and the AI model is working properly. It's not perfect, but it's working quite well. And that's all. We just started the container and now it's running and with other terminals showing the activities in the background.
Yeah, and it shows the custom vision will label the appropriate fruit type, right? And what's that number next to it?
Confidence level, meaning that, the AI model believes that for about 80% of confidence, it's 80% confident that that is an apple, it's a banana, something like that. And as you keep training, improving the AI model, you will see higher and higher confidence level.
Yeah, I mean, that's a pretty good degree of confidence with just, you know, an hour or two or just a couple minutes of training the model. So
right. And the good thing is that I can keep retraining that and deploying that within seconds.
Exactly.
All right. But Speaking of retraining AI models, we first of all, we'll have to know the inference result and the performance of that model or container. So what we do is that we integrate, I mean, DeviceOn has integrated with some third-party visualization tools like Power BI, or in this case, I'm going to show you Grafana. There are some SDKs and APIs offered by DeviceOn that you can call to retrieve data from the edge devices. So if you turn back on my screen, you will see that this is a Grafana dashboard, and it's showing all the activities on that AI container. You will see that we are showing the inference results, how many times we've detected the apples and bananas and oranges, and we are also showing the performance or the computing power of this edge device and container. So this is a wonderful tool for you to quickly visualize and to analyze the inference results and data from the edge device.
Very neat, very, very cool. Well, and how do I get access to all of this? So this is a really seamless solution. How do I follow in your exact footsteps if I wanted to try this out for myself?
Well, to know more about this best practice or this pipeline, you can go to the link below this video, and you will get on to our solution page under Azure Certified Device Program. So go to the solution page, and you can find us under Azure Certified Device Program, which is a wonderful program for developers and OEM companies like us.
Okay, so I'll definitely look you guys up in the Azure Marketplace and in the Azure Certified Device Catalog for the NVIDIA Jetson and then DeviceOn solution. That's great. Thank you so much. And again, viewers, if you want to look at this full demo and follow these steps yourself, please follow the link down below. Thank you so much for joining the show today, Stephen. This was a wonderful walkthrough.